It's like a filtration system, to use an awkward and irrelevant metaphor. If you care enough about something to do ethnographic research on it, you must have some kind of a meaningful connection to it, or maybe a personal stake in it, more likely, or a political position on it, probably. You can study almost any topic, almost anywhere in the world in anthropology, so the one that you pick must really matter to you. The first filter is the researcher, their self, their identity, their beliefs, their priorities, and how that shapes what they want to study. Next filter is the social, political, the cultural context in which you do the research. All of that interacts with the first filter to shape who you talk to shape the questions you can ask, what you can record as data. Then the researcher comes back from the so-called field and starts either writing it up or editing the clips together into a film, or whatever the case may be. And at that point, it's all filtered through their values and belief systems yet again. As the product gets finalized, the data becomes presentations, becomes papers, articles, books, ethnographic films, 2-minute YouTube videos. Some things make the cut, some things get emphasized over others. Hundreds, maybe thousands of little decisions go into this stage. Even for this 2-minute video about kind of an abstract concept, I probably had to make like 80 decisions about where to cut and where to paste, etc. I don't think any two people would make the same decisions all the way through any project at any scale. Then those products go out into the world. We never know how our products will get received. Obviously, nobody can control this step, or if we could, every ethnography would win every award there is, and, you know, maybe sell billions of copies, as opposed to the dozens of copies that most ethnography sell. So the politics of representation means how all those filters shape research and shape how that research is then received, because there's also no single objective way to receive and make sense of any one representation. To make the most out of our reading of these sources, the context has to be factored in. There's no objective information about culture that was made in some kind of a magical no politics vacuum, as much as many people still like to pretend there is. If you don't agree, argue with me or make your own video, but don't click the thumbs down button, because that only amplifies the reach of this, I think. I don't know.